please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
UltraTech Cement, of course, will be declaring numbers and that will be on our radar as well. Numbers come out later today. Nigel, what are we expecting?
Well, Anuj, we'll look out for the numbers at around 2 to around 2.30 p.m. Today. In terms of the numbers, top line, big growth we're going to see there. Close to around 29% in terms of a top line growth. Majority of the top line growth is only because of sales volumes. So the sales volumes numbers that we're working with is around 17.5 million tons. Now, how do we see such a big jump up in terms of sales volumes? Well, that's because the acquired JP Cement's assets, that's going to be consolidated in the books. So that's what gives a big rise to the top line. In terms of realizations, well, that'll be as flat as can be. Maybe a percent higher or a percent lower. But bulk of the top line comes in only because of sales volumes. For the acquired JP Cement's assets, we're looking at capacity utilization levels of around 60%. Remember, in the first quarter of this fiscal, it was only around 15%. So good top line growth, but in terms of operating profit, that'll come up by only around 14 to around 15%, telling you that when you have a top line growth of 28% and you have only 15% in terms of an operating profit growth, margins should get compressed by around 200 basis points. Why is that? Realizations are flattish. JP Cements, yes, that'll help the top line, but in terms of profitability or EBITDA per ton, that's lower than what UltraTech Cement normally gets. And when you have flat realizations and your input cost goes up, like pet coke as well as diesel, that's what compresses margins. Profit number, that'll degrow by close to around 20%. That's because, in fact, the acquired JP Cement's assets will lead to higher interest costs as well as higher depreciation costs. 2:30 p.m., we should get it today. Back to you.
Okay, thank you very much for that, Nigel.